Did you know, according to the Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, over 53,000 cases of cyber security incidents were reported in 2017 in India.
35 to 38% of total porn uploaded on the web is related to children or teenagers. Search engines get over 116,000 queries every day related to child pornography.
According to the International Association of Internet Hotlines, the number of web pages containing child sexual abuse material increased by 147% from 2012 to 2014.
In this video, we shall discuss what is online child sexual exploitation. Know your rights. Report child sexual abuse and exploitation. Reporting to human rights. Do your kids have access to internet?
Do they have account in any social media platform like Facebook, Instagram or Twitter?
Has your child ever accepted friend request from anyone whom you do not know personally?
Has your kid ever chatted with an unknown person over the internet?
If your kid answers yes to any of these questions, beware, your child is vulnerable to online sexual abuse. Children these days have internet access from a very young age. With the ongoing pandemic COVID-19, schools have been forced to take lessons through internet. Smartphones have become accessible to children like never before. All children who use internet can fall prey to online sexual abuse if they are not careful with their digital presence. Online child sexual abuse is a unique form of child abuse, also known as cyber molestation, due to its virtual, distanced, and anonymous nature. Online child abuse has become rampant because the internet makes it very easy for the perpetrator to remain anonymous and hide his, her true identity. A perpetrator can be in any country of the world and still sexually abuse a child online. This makes the work of law enforcement agencies also very tough, as the laws related to online sexual abuse are not uniform in all the countries.
There can be various types of online child sexual abuses. A child can be subjected online grooming, cyber stalking, cyber harassment, cyber bullying, sexting, sextortion or revenge porn. A victim can face long and short term effects. This can cause fear, shame, guilt and self-pity in the victim. The victim may also blame oneself for the abuse. This can result in loss of sleep, appetite and concentration, and the grades of the victim may fall. The scars of online child abuse can remain lifelong. You can protect your kids from online child sexual abuses. Never accept friend requests from strangers or people whom you have never met. They can be potential perpetrators. Always check the privacy settings of the various online platforms that you visit. When you are online, you may see various pop-ups or advertisements. Do not open or click such images. It can be spyware and can make you susceptible to online abuse. Be careful about uploading your personal images and information online. It can be misused by the perpetrator.
You don't need to be scared of the perpetrator. Your kids have not done anything wrong, and please don't let them feel alone. If you ever feel that your kids are in such a situation where they are being abused, then please let your kids know that they have your trust and confidence. Teacher can also help in gaining children's confidence. Stop all communication with the abuser immediately and deactivate all online accounts through which the perpetrator contacts the child. Report the crime to police or Special Juvenile Police Units (SJPU). You may also call Childline 1098.
What are the various laws in our country to protect children from sexual abuse?
The government of the country is taking this issue very seriously, and laws are being implemented to protect children from online sexual abuse. We have the Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act 2012 and the IT Act 2006 to punish the perpetrators and give justice to victims. Let us take care of our children. Stop child abuse. Don't forget to share the video to create awareness. Goodbye. See you soon.